Good evening to you and thank you for joining the Super Screen TV News at 6. I am Kiruka Ibe and now looking at matters arising ahead of the February 16 polls. President Muhammadu Buhari, former Vice President Atiku Abubakar and other presidential candidates have signed a second peace accord ahead of Saturday's presidential election. The presidential candidates signed the agreement today at the International Conference Center in Abuja, the nation's capital. Those who witnessed the signing included the Secretary General of the Commonwealth, Patricia Scotland, former Head of State General Abdusalami Abubakar retired, Bishop Matthew Kuhar, as well as other members of the National Peace Committee, NPC. Addressing the gathering shortly after the arrival of the guest, Chairman of the NPC, General Abdusalam Abubakar, urged political parties to function as effective actors of peace before, during and after the election. And speaking on behalf of the candidates, President Muhammadu Buhari of the All Progressives Congress APC called for prayers as the nation goes to the polls, urging the youths to avert all forms of violence. And the Kaduna State Command of the Department of State Services, DSS, has given reasons why it arrested the Kaduna People's Democratic Party campaign DG Ben Bako. The security outfit said it picked up Bako because of a recent inciting statement credited to him, stressing that if left unchecked, the comment is capable of leading to a complete breakdown of law and order in the state and beyond. However, the PDP in the state has accused the action of the DSS as premeditated, stressing that the party was aware of the ruling APC plan to arrest top leaders of the opposition party. You'll recall that the PDP campaign DG Ben Bako was arrested after a video in which he allegedly called for anybody that fails to vote for the PDP in the forthcoming elections to be killed. The People's Democratic Party's PDP presidential candidate in the 2019 general elections, Atiku Abubakar and Peter Obi, were in Lagos to campaign for votes from Lagos electorates. Super Screen's Michael Semeke reports that the PDP condemned insecurity and unemployment in the country. Let's take a look.
Despite being a work day, supporters of the People's Democratic Party, PDP, trooped out to give the duo of Atiku Abubakar and Peter Obi a warm welcome to the State of Excellence. At the campaign rally held at the Tafabalewa Square, Atiku Abubakar based his campaign on joblessness and insecurity, describing it as the hallmark of the All Progressives Congress-led government. On the entourage of Atiku Abubakar were his running mate Peter Obi, the Senate President and the Director General of Atiku Presidential Campaign, Olusola Saraki, PDP Chairman Uche Secondus, the governorship candidate of the PDP in Lagos State, Jimmy Agbaji, amongst other dignitaries. They all took turns in highlighting the challenges facing Nigeria and the way forward.
We are here because you know the value of our country and Atiku Abubakar. When you vote for Atiku Abubakar, you vote for a better economy. When you vote for a better economy, you vote for jobs for the youth.
Other party stalwarts used the occasion to canvass for Lagos votes.
Atiku is a member of the private sector. I am incidentally a vice president of the Lagos Chamber of Commerce and Industry. I understand what it is when we say that government has no business in business. But if we have a businessman at the helm of affairs, he will understand that and he will give due to the private sector.
Atiku has a special interest in Nigeria. That is why all this why he had wanted to be the president. And unlike President Muhammadu Buhari, as Atiku is an investor.
Atiku Abubakar has the pedigree. Atiku Abubakar has what it takes. He's been there and we saw what he did. He did a lot. He brought in new innovations. Look at the telecoms, look at look at the transformation there.
On Saturday, everybody in Truba and vote Atiku. Vote Atiku Obi.
My president Atiku is ready. He's already a winner. By February 16th, I want them to come out for a man that you know that is capable.
It remains to be seen how the election will play out on Saturday, February 16, 2019. Mike Osemeke reporting for Super Screen News.
The United Kingdom, UK, says it will deploy 100 or more than 100 observers in 15 states for the general elections. British High Commissioner to Nigeria, Katana Leng, who disclosed this to journalists in Abuja, said UK respects Nigeria's sovereignty and will help it to strengthen its democracy by standing with its people in their democratic journey. Leng said the process is what matters to them and that it is why they will be deploying over 100 observers in 15 states to support observer missions from the European Union, United States, diplomatic mission in Nigeria and all the local observers. The High Commissioner stressed that they are confident that many things have been put in place since 2015 to strengthen the process, adding that they have invested heavily as a partner with the Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, and civil societies to strengthen those institutions and make the process stronger. And on the other hand, Amnesty International has called on the federal government to protect the people from violence before, during and after the coming general elections. Ahead of the poll scheduled for February 16 and March 2nd, the Human Rights Organization also called for the full respect for freedom of expression, peaceful assembly and association. It said there have been several instances of violence at election campaign rallies in some states, including the death of four people in clashes between rival political supporters in Kano State in December 2018. The group urged the federal government to stamp out any potential impunity by ensuring these incidents are investigated and those suspected to be responsible are brought to justice. And the United States Ambassador at Large for International Religious Freedom, Samuel Brownback, has called on religious leaders in Nigeria to send out clear messages against violence during the forthcoming general elections. Brownback, who gave the advice at a news conference on international religious freedom, said the whole world is watching the Nigeria's general elections scheduled for February 16 and March 2nd. The ambassador also said the United States government is strongly concerned about free and fair elections in Nigeria, devoid of any violent attacks. The Independent National Electoral Commission, INEC, says voters can use any finger because the ballot paper is not finger sensitive. The electoral umpire advised that what matters is that the finger does not cross to the next box, otherwise it will be interpreted as voting for two parties, making such votes void. The commission said this in response to what it called fake news that has been making the rounds to the intent that voters could only use a certain finger. And the federal government has inaugurated a special committee to investigate allegations of sexual abuse of vulnerable minors at the FCT School for the Deaf in Kuje. The permanent secretary, Federal Ministry of Education, Sonia Kunohu, disclosed this at the inauguration of the committee members, condemned the grievous allegations based on the ages involved. Ekuno asked the committee, who are drawn from mainly the public and civil society organizations, to cast their nest far and wide to do a thorough investigation and recommend appropriate measures that will prevent a recurrence.
Special committee to investigate allegations of sexual abuse of vulnerable minors at the FCT School for the Deaf, Kuje. It has 15 members. 15 members, five of whom are from the public defense ministry and FCT, including the secretary, making six. So there are six people from the two ministries. Well, FCT in this context is not a ministry, but the equivalent of a state. That's why they're handling primary education. There are six of them, while the remaining members are from other stakeholders and NGOs and so on and so forth.
And now on to other matters in the health sector. Health workers under the ages of medical and health workers of Ibobi Orthopedic Hospital Lagos have threatened to embark on an indefinite strike if government fails to address what they describe as endemic corruption in the health system. The workers who carried placards with various messages alleged that corruption has crippled the sector, maintaining that the abandonment of the system for years has resulted to its decay in administration and service.
The Joint Health Sector Unions of Nigeria in health sector have declared 3 days work to rule in all the hospitals in Nigeria. It will be inclusive. And that's why we're here. They declared that we should have a rally from 8 o'clock in the morning to 12 o'clock in the afternoon, after which we'll go back to our duty to posts to continue the work. And the whole idea is to tell Nigerians and the government that all the agreements reached with them in the past, nothing has come out of it. Even after going through the ADR, that is the department in NICN, that is National Industrial Court of Nigeria, that is responsible for dispute resolution. Okay, we have gone through that. A journey that was supposed to take 21 days took 6 months. At the end of the day, still nothing happened.
Most of our decisions have not been attended to by the government. For instance, the promotion arrears that we're supposed to have gotten, we have not been paid. You can imagine 2018 promotion arrears of our members have not been paid. In 2014, we made a move for the adjustment of core health salary as zone to medical doctors, but up till now, it has not been effected. And that of the medical doctors have been affected twice, if not thrice.
This is a complete demonstration of our frustration. It's a complete demonstration of unhappiness. It's a complete demonstration of the unfair treatment that is being meted out to health workers in the health sector. And we are saying that this is unacceptable and we can no longer take this. A situation where you have two parties within the health sector, the medical personnel and the other and the rest of other healthcare professionals. And you have a situation where one party is being treated fairly and the other party is treated unjustly. And we're saying no, everybody is important in the system and the system must be fair to all.
These health workers are demanding a holistic turnaround in the health sector to enable Nigerians have access to quality healthcare while calling for an upper salary structure.
I know the government is not aware, especially the president, His Excellency President Muhammad Buhari, he's not aware of the what the professor is doing, because he's no more a professor of health, or rather the minister of health. He's now the minister of doctors. He's enslaving other health workers and preferring the doctors. We are carrying out this protest so that he will be aware. The public will be sensitized, and the message we get to him that he can salvage what is happening in the health sector, because the minister there is not capable of managing the whole health sector. He's preferring one part to the other.
We want federal government to mediate in this matter. You can see that all over the nations, rally are going on simultaneously in Lodz, in UCH, all over its institutions. And we will not go to relent. We are not going to relent on this until our money is being paid. We have the support of our members. You can see large crowds. You can see some of them. You can see many of them. After this rally, we are coming out with another thing. Unless you are being paid, no going back. No retreat, no surrender.
Well, we hope their grievances are heard. And away from that, a federal high court in Abuja has adjourned the alleged examination malpractice and certificate forgery suit filed against Senator Ademola Adeleke until April 2nd to enable the prosecution file additional evidence. Justice Inang Okoro, who fixed the date today when prosecution counsel Simon Lo prayed the court for leave to file additional evidence. The court adjourned the matter until April 2nd, 3rd and 4th for accelerated hearing. You recall that Senator Adeleke was arraigned in 2018 on allegations of examination malpractice and certificate forgery. And in Edo State Commissioner of Police CP Hakim Odumosu has arrested six persons in connection with a young girl who was allegedly beaten and molested for stealing iPhone X mask worth 440,000 naira. The CP disclosed this to journalists in Benin City while giving updates on the incident.
This is Favor Ada. The young girl who was allegedly beaten and molested for stealing iPhone X mask of 440,000 naira in Benin, precisely at Ugiuko community in Ego local government area of Edo State. Favor was dehumanized by some men at a hotel and they inserted pepper in a private part without fear of the law. Speaking with Favor, she said she was framed up by one of the guys identified as Joel Otogile because she refused to give him a room at the hotel where she works.
I know my sister, want to tell my sister, say, how you take, no. I know my sister, want to say, my friend, tell her, say, they take care of my dog. They go, come, they argue. Then he come for me, he made me come down. And he, sister, my dog, and they say, for me, I want to show on the paper of the dog, so you see the paper here, they take. Then he come, say, okay, see, now you say, but you know, they hide there. So I say, let me bring out the phone, maybe I take. Let me bring out the phone, let me take. I say, whose phone? Send me no second, you see, now I lie, see, now me take. Then one of them come slap me to the face. Man, go bring out the phone to get it. I said, me no carry phone, no carry phone. Now the man won't carry two bullets. Put inside my stomach. Come say, let me go confess. I said, yes, let me carry phone, no take phone, no collect phone. Now the man said, let me go confess. I said, no collect phone, no take phone. Now the man come say, okay, since service are not good to hospital, say the bullet will cost my belly, so I go die.
The suspects are Otogile Joel, Lucky Igbinfia, 56 years of age, also known as One Man Squad, 30-year-old Edobo Osewinge and 50-year-old Kingsley Yamu. They speak on their roles.
One guy called Thompson, he's a brother to this very man. He came to me and said, bros, we have been waiting for you since. So I said, what happened? He said, the girl they collected in my place, that they stole his brother's phone. I said, who is your brother? Who is your brother? This one now came out. When he now came out, he said, bros, he said, one of your girls here stole my phone. How are you sure that it's the girl that stole your phone? He said, why am I saying that? He said, he's sure. He said, because the girl was with them. Before the girl left, they didn't know. And I said, what's the name of the girl? They mentioned it, that and I sent for the girl. The girl now came out. I said, my dear, they said you stole their phone. How did it come? The girl now explained to me that direct. She did not steal this boy's phone. And when they took her to meet the boy, the brother, when they were there, he saw these boys bringing out Ramadan and some other substance. They were putting inside beer to drink. He said that when he saw that, he had to use our own brain that he cannot be able to withstand these boys.
Owner of King's Lodge called me that there are a troop of boys in his hotel that they want to kill his girl, one of his girl. And I asked him that I'm at home. When they came to my house, they said the girl stole a phone. I asked, this is the owner of the phone, which I asked the owner of the phone. Did this officer say this girl has stole his phone? And I asked Black, as it is, if you know you cannot settle this matter with the way I'm looking at it, better take this matter to the station. Which I hand over the girl to Black, put him inside his vehicle in front of my house. I drove out and locked my gate, knowing it to me that the same people have blocked Black Iyamu, drove that girl out of his car, beat him senseless on the road, not in my compound. I did not witness the beating. I did not witness how they put pepper in her private part. The girl can also say, it's a barbaric act and I condemn it. So I'm not a party to what they did.
Addressing journalists on the issue, Edo State Commissioner of Police Hakim Odumosu said the command has arrested six persons in connection to the matter.
They didn't even report a case of a missing phone. So they only alleged. From investigation so far, they feel that they just want to punish her deliberately because they feel that they are grinding time and all. The elderly lady that was, who happens to be the chairperson of that group, that was the one that was contacted to bring a friend of hers to come and stay. So a man friend of that lady now, so contacted the lady, who they call chairman of their group, and said, chairman, bring somebody for us to come and stay with us. So now contacted this female victim, went there. So the victim now, they have discovered that this boy, there's five of them, grinding tramadol to put in their drinks. She know what tramadol is. She know the effect of tramadol. She now tell her, since you are taking tramadol, I will not stay again. Then with that one, she left. Then I asked the woman, the chairperson, that how did she know that they are doing tramadol? She said it was this lady that she brought that told them.
The CP further urged parents and guardians to watch over the associates of their children or words to guard against bad company. At the time of filing this report, the suspects are being taken to court.
And here we'll take a short break, and when we return, we'll give you business-related stories. Stay with us. You're welcome back, and thank you for staying with us. And now talking business, the federal government has commenced the construction of the 16-kilometer Ofeme Community Road project located in Umuahia North Local Government Area of Abia State. The Minister of Industry, Trade and Investments, Okechukwu Enemele, who disclosed this to journalists during the flag off of the project in Ofeme, said the project will boost economic activities within the community and its environs. NMLS said the community road project is expected to be delivered under the federal government's Road Infrastructure Development and Refurbishment Investment Tax Credit Scheme. The minister called on the people to give the contractor the needed cooperation to enable it to complete the road project in record time of 1 year, as stated in the contractual agreement. The federal government says it has ordered power generation companies to go find customers and sell their power directly to the identified customers instead of waiting for electricity distributors to sell the power or for payments from the government for the shortfalls in their GenCo's revenues. Permanent Secretary, Federal Ministry of Power, Works and Housing, Louis Edozien, who disclosed this to journalists in Abuja, said the Power Sector Reform Act never intended that government will continue to pay for shortfalls. According to the government, plans are on the way for it to ultimately exit the monthly payment of GenCos to help cushion the revenue shortfalls on the books of the power generators as a result of the power remittances from the power distributors. You recall that the federal government had in 2017 announced a commitment of 702 billion naira through the Nigerian Bulk Electricity Trading Company to generate the payment of electricity generated and supplied power generation companies. The Nigerian Stock Exchange, NSE, says investors in the nation's stock market gained 253.7 billion naira as the market capitalization of equities listed in the Nigerian Stock Exchange rose above the 12 trillion naira mark. Equities listed on the NSE extended their gains streak to the 8th consecutive day, the longest since July 2017, as investors stepped up their bids on a market-pleasing outcome. The market capitalization increased from 11.852 trillion naira on Monday to 12.105 trillion naira on Tuesday, while the All Share Index increased by 2.1% from 31,781.87 basis point on Monday to its highest level in almost 4 months at 32,462.31 BPS on Tuesday. However, activity level improved on Tuesday as volume and value traded for the day increased by 5.5% and 42.2% to 580.413 million units and 8 billion naira respectively. And here we take another short break, and when we return, we give you foreign and sports stories. Stay with us.